Kallmann syndrome is an endocrine disorder caused by a decrease in sex hormones, either testosterone in males or estrogen and progesterone in females. That decrease leads to a failure to start or complete puberty. The syndrome is named after Dr. Franz Kallmann, the geneticist who first described it. Normally, during fetal development, there's a region of the brain called the olfactory placote. Two groups of neurons emerge from that region. The first group contains olfactory neurons that eventually help with sensing smells. These neurons migrate from the olfactory placode and get embedded in the cribriform plate, which is a bone plate that separates the nasal cavity from the brain, forming the olfactory bulb. The second group contains neurons that release gonadotropin-releasing hormone, and these neurons migrate through the cribriform plate and settle in the hypothalamus. The hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis is a system of hormone signalling between the hypothalamus, pituitary gland, and gonads, either the testes or the ovaries, to control sexual development and reproduction. Gonadotropin-releasing hormone is released into the hypophyseal portal system, which is a network of capillaries connecting the hypothalamus to the hypophysis, or pituitary. When gonadotropin-releasing hormone reaches the pituitary gland, it stimulates cells in the anterior pituitary, called gonadotrophs, to release gonadotropin hormones, luteinizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone, into the blood. These gonadotropin hormones then stimulate the gonads to produce sex-specific hormones. These are estrogen and progesterone in women and testosterone in men. Early on in male development, testosterone helps the external sex organs to differentiate into male genitals and causes the testes to descend from the abdomen into the scrotal sac. During puberty, the Leydig cells of the testes respond to the luteinizing hormone by converting more cholesterol into testosterone. The high levels of testosterone leads to the development of primary sex characteristics like penile and testicular growth. In addition, the Sertoli cells of the testes respond to follicle-stimulating hormone by producing more sperm. Increased testosterone also leads to the development of secondary sex characteristics, like growth of facial and pubic hair, increased height and muscle mass, and a deepening of the voice. In females, the theca cells respond to luteinizing hormone by producing progesterone and androstenedione. Then, follicle-stimulating hormone causes the granulosa cells to convert androstenedione into estrogen. During puberty, waves of estrogen and progesterone regulate primary sex characteristics, like monthly changes to the ovary stroma to promote egg maturation and ovulation, and changes to the uterine wall lining as part of the menstrual cycle. They also direct secondary sex characteristic development, like increased height and growth of pubic hair and breasts. In Kallmann syndrome, there's a defect in the migration of neurons coming out of the olfactory placode. That includes the olfactory neurons, which can result in hyposmia, which is a reduced sense of smell, or anosmia, which is a complete loss of smell. It also includes gonadotropin-releasing hormone neurons, which results in a decrease in gonadotropin-releasing hormone. And that leads to low levels of gonadotropin hormones, luteinizing and follicle-stimulating hormone, and low levels of gonadal function. In males, there's a decrease in testosterone, and in females, there's a decrease in progesterone and estrogen. The disruption in hormones prevents puberty from beginning or successfully completing. Because of this, Kallmann syndrome is a type of hypogonadotropic hypogonadism disorder. In Kallmann syndrome, there's an underdevelopment of primary and secondary sex characteristics. In males, primary sex characteristic dysfunction includes having a small penis and testes, improper testicular descent, and a low sperm count. Secondary sex characteristic dysfunction includes a lack of facial hair, low muscle mass, and not developing a deep voice. In females, primary sex characteristic dysfunction includes amenorrhea, or absence of menstruation, or oligomenorrhea, or irregular menstruation. Secondary sex characteristic dysfunction includes a lack of breast development and pubic hair. For both males and females, Kallmann syndrome often leads to infertility. Other non-reproductive symptoms include osteoporosis or osteopenia, because testosterone and estrogen are protective against bone resorption. A diagnosis of Kallmann syndrome is made based on identifying low levels of gonadotropin-releasing hormone, low gonadotropins, LH and FSH, and low sex hormones, estrogen, progesterone and testosterone. And this is all with normal levels of other pituitary hormones. Genetic tests for known gene mutations associated with Kallmann syndrome can also be done. And finally, there's usually an abnormal smell test and sperm count as well. Treatment is focused on hormone therapy, which can stimulate puberty and the development of secondary sex characteristics. There's also infertility treatment, which can make reproduction possible in some cases. So to recap, Kallmann syndrome is a type of hypogonadotropic hypogonadism, where olfactory neurons and gonadotropin-releasing hormone neurons don't function normally. The decrease in sex hormones inhibits the development of primary and secondary sex characteristics during puberty. Hi everyone, Sarah here. Thanks for watching that video on Kallmann syndrome. I hope you found it useful. The script was written by Amanda and it was edited by Rishi and Ifan. I did the illustration and the voiceover, and the whole thing was edited by Sam. So big thanks to the team who made this happen. We really hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it and you've enjoyed other videos you've seen on the Osmosis YouTube channel, then what you need to do is head over to osmosis.org if you haven't already. Not only do we have more videos that aren't released on YouTube, but there are tons more resources which are super useful for medical school. It's just the perfect base for your learning, with questions, flashcards, and tips and tricks to organise your studies. So I definitely recommend that. As a past medical student myself, and now a qualified doctor, it works! So enjoy, and head over to our Facebook page and leave us a review if you don't mind. And also interact with us on Twitter, Instagram, and other social media platforms. And I look forward to creating the next video for you guys. Bye!